various exciting things are happening in local fashion. We seem to be developing a look from not just Trinidad and Tobago, but from the Caribbean. It's good news because there's going to be a show very soon. It's going to be called The Rage, and I can tell you the fashion will be all the rage when that show is over. It is with great pleasure that I welcome three people this morning. Godfrey Sealy. Godfrey, nice to have you again on the program.
Thank
We've
you.
Talked a few times before. Seated next to him, Anne Ardain, who is a garment designer, and next to her, Liz Gardner, who is a jewelry designer and also a fabric designer. Okay, ladies, I'm sorry, it's going to be gentlemen first. Godfrey, The Rage, when is it taking place?
It's on Wednesday the 22nd, which is next week Wednesday at 7:30 at the Queen's Hall.
At the Queen's Hall. How soon can we get tickets for this show?
Well, tickets have been available for past 2 weeks, I think, and they're all over in the boutiques downtown in South, in Arima, and at Queen's Hall, and from the designers and models.
Right, I guess that people ought to try and get their tickets as quickly as possible.
Yes, we're trying to sell as many tickets before, because there's always a confusion on the night when people decide that they're finally coming.
And if they want to get to the show, I think they ought to get tickets, because it's going to be a big one. How many designers do you have participating?
We have 5, as we did last year, and they're all, well, relatively new. We're trying to bring them, open them up to the market. They're the Homework Alpha. We have the experience. This is part of the experience here. Anne and Liz, their look is called The Plantation. We have Ricardo Guy James. You just saw some of his clothes there with his brother, Ronald Guy James, who was in the show last year. We have Richie Richardson. And we have The Cloth.
Right. Will you be doing your clothes as well, or you just...
No, I'm just coordinating. No.
Just coordinating.
Yes.
All right. And as a garment designer, take it. I mean, I can see that there's still youth around your face there. It means that you're quite new in the business.
Well, yes, at least in Trinidad, but I studied abroad for quite some time, and I just came back last year. You know,
where did you study?
At FIT, Fashion Institute of Technology. Yes. I studied there for about 4 years, and I worked in the industry in New York for about 6 to 8 months.
Yes. What I said earlier on about when I looked at the clothes, it is definitely a difference in the kind of fashion we're seeing coming out of Trinidad and Tobago.
Definitely.
Now. As someone who was trained in America, do you then have to come back and start thinking completely differently?
No, I think that I always had my identity, because I feel within the Caribbean there is something sort of vibrant that is far different from what's happening in New York and also in Europe. And I think that's another reason too why I came back, because I think the Caribbean has their own identity, you know, which I think should be worldwide also.
Mm, so you don't think pushing New York fashions on
Not
us?
Not at all.
You know, and I wonder though, because we are talking a lot and a great deal about saving money and therefore cutting
right.
on imports.
Right.
Do you, however, see that we will soon be able to take an export market very seriously? Can you see our clothes?
Well, I think so to an extent. Like I said, once again, I don't think we should look towards New York and Europe for the flavor of our clothing. I think we should mainly keep it with that Caribbean influence. And I think in that light, maybe we will find a market, because nowhere else is doing hand-painted original stuff, which I think is becoming very popular down here. And I think we're also doing very loose, comfortable, wearable stuff that's very, very Caribbean,
yes.
You know.
All right, you're part of a group called The Experience,
yes.
Is it? Liz, perhaps you can tell me a bit about this group. Who are the people involved? When were you formed? Why?
Well, Anne and I really started together, and we met Lawrence Fredericks, and he put us on to Godfrey. We had started doing work for the boutique at Calypso Beach Resort, and I hadn't really been working in fabric for a while, but I have been doing batik tie-dyeing and so on for about 13 years, and I suppose with her expertise she sort of built my confidence to get back into it. So that's what how our energies sort of pooled, and why we're doing this show now, that we share studio space, so we work together constantly every day, and we share our ideas. So she helps me with color and that sort of thing, and I want to get into eventually, I think after this show, I want to start working on garments that are dyed, but extracted dyes from natural vegetable bark, roots, and flowers. My aunt from Canada, Daphne Stolmeyer, was just down there, and she has put me on to somebody to find out how to extract the dyes from these things.
Yes. I wonder where is the plantation, because Godfrey said something about, besides you being the experience, that you were...
Well, Anne and I are... our label that we're now going through, getting it passed, etc., is Plantation. Just Anne and myself working together. Lawrence, Anne and myself came together for this show.
I see.
But we are working together on our own stuff.
Yeah. Lawrence is the look, and his whole feeling for fashion is totally different from ours. You know, he does very sort of structured stuff where we're very loose, but we've come together under the same umbrella of the experience.
Right, so it'd be a nice sort of combination of
yes,
ideas.
Yes, very
looking
much
forward
so.
To seeing it. Godfrey, you were mentioning there's some of the designers who are involved, and you say this is the second show that you're having. What motivated you in the first place to get involved and to have this type of show?
I don't know. Last year, early in the year, I was friendly with some of the designers that took part in the last rage, and we were talking about young designers not getting enough airplay, because you find that a lot of people know the more established designers, and there are many younger designers who have been producing clothes for quite some time and have never been really popularized. So we thought that if we would come together and maybe sort of form a cooperative where we could get people who were interested and serious in producing garments, and we could probably approach the MDC or the IDC so they could get loans for machinery and stuff like that, we could sort of help them to expand on their cottage industries. So we said the only way to show off the talent was to start an expose. So we thought that every year we would do a trade show, which we would call The Rage. The name was derived from the five designers that took part last year, because The Rage is their feeling that they want to come out, you know. And we did it, and it was successful, because four of the five designers now have their own boutiques, and they got a lot of airplay. And from that, I think so many things have been happening. They have encouraged a lot of other young designers to continue with their work. And now this year we have five new designers, and there are so many more outside, you know, we're waiting for next year's show.
Well, I'm sure that there might be some designers this morning who already are saying, hey, I want to get in touch with him, because I'd like... Do you screen the people first? I mean, because obviously there's many, as they say, many are called, but few are chosen.
Well, I can't say we do screen. You would find that there are a lot of... You would find the serious ones that are around. Either they would get in contact, or you would find that their clothes are appearing at the boutiques. The smaller boutiques where they sell designer clothing. And that's how I think we get in touch with the people who are manufacturing and not just doing it as a hobby, you know. So that's how we get it. Fortunately, we haven't really had an influx of people trying to get in. We have a few others who are interested, but they have just started. And you would find that soon after the show is finished on Wednesday, the customers that will come into these people, they need to have clothes already, you know, prepared.
Yes, you can't be taking orders,
no,
in other words.
Exactly.
You have to sell.
So that's why we choose people who already have clothing or who've been selling clothing previously and stuff. You know, so if you've been doing clothing for a few months or whatever, you're sort of eligible to participate in the rage.
Yes. Godfrey, what about the actual show? What form will it take? Is it the usual catwalk we'll be seeing?
No.
Oh, sorry, I asked.
I think that trend in fashion shows, it's long dying, particularly with the young designers. They have their own psyche about their clothing. Their clothing is something very spiritual to them. They don't just design clothes to sell, you know? I mean, when you paint a piece of fabric or you design something with character, you're not just doing it to sell, it's something that is part of you. And that's what we're trying to portray. Every designer will portray their clothing with their own particular theme. The overlying theme for the show this year is electronic wave, because we're moving to a wave of the future, and our future might be our development in design and fashion and the industry here. And it's very computerized and futuristic, not totally space futuristic, but new ideas, you know, plans for the future and stuff like that. And they all have their own individual ideas, concepts. So you'll find that you'll have five different concepts. It's going to be very theatrical.
Oh, it sounds lovely. And have yourself and Liz worked out the way you'll be presenting your fashion?
Yeah, we are thinking of going, like Godfrey said, very spiritual initially, with lots of white and sort of very... I made a lot of jackets out of wool, which are very soft. And then we're moving into a whole area of color, which is also loose, and then into some very squared structured jackets, and then we're ending in black, which is once again loose. Mm-hmm. So it goes through many different moods and many different colors and feelings, you know.
Now, so I was thinking there about between Liz and yourself, she's doing the fabric, you're doing the clothes. Mm-hmm. Do you have to have close meetings with each other to decide what colors? Because obviously she might come up with some type of combination.
We share studio space, yes. So we work usually for the last 2 weeks. We've been working from about 10 in the morning until 3 the next morning.
You must be exhausted.
Because I've done so far close to 100 yards of fabric, hand-painted and dyed. And all the colors, we haven't bought any colored fabric. I've dyed everything.
Every single thing. Everything. What about the mood of your colors? Have you worked in any sort of
earthy
theme?
All earthy colors. But enable for the earthy colors to shine forth, we had to throw in a little bright color in between, because it really would have been a little bit dead on stage, because a lot of the, we're not using metallics, all the jewelry, I'm doing all the jewelry, the accessories for our section, and we're using very earthy tones like coppers, olive greens, ash grays, blacks, and stuff like that. Now, in between those sections, we had to throw in a few pieces with color in order to have a little surprise in the section, you know, yes, a little boost of color.
Sounds lovely.
Which is Caribbean. You know?
Will you be using her jewelry to enhance your clothes?
Definitely. What I did is that I came up with the design concepts and we both discussed it, and she said, okay, she thinks that these colors will go so and whatnot. And then afterwards, from there, we are sort of designing the jewelry to go with the clothing, and Liz is making everything.
Sounds lovely. So now, you say there's going to be quite a lot of loose clothing and big jackets, so that's the look that you have for 87.
I would say very comfortable, and I think loose is also very cool, which will suit the Caribbean and the, you know, the environment that we live in.